Welcome one and all to a new design video. Yay, we're doing another design video. Woo! I have gotten another person asking to do designs, so I shall oblige. Today we are going to be doing 5 Dune Racer designs. As you can see, this is the first design already. Wow, spoilers, let's go. But yeah, I'll get right into it after I shout out the person. It is Finn Tucson. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. I'm very sorry if I didn't. Thank you very much. He asked for Dune Racer designs twice in my Jeopardy video and in an older video as well. So I thought, hey, why not? That sounds like a good idea. If you guys have any suggestions for future designs you want me to do, let me know. I'll shout you out in the next video. And yeah, so let's get right on with it. Woo! Right, so this is going to be our first design. We have a Cobalt Dune Racer. Now, as you can see, I call it Henko because I kind of got inspired by Henkovic's design, but we'll come to that later. Now, we do use a Cobalt Octane. I don't have one at the moment, so I'm using Bacchus mod for it. We're using a Cobalt Dune Racer. And I like to go with these colors. Like, I just picked out these colors. You can go with like a different green if you want to, maybe like a more like bright green, but I like the minty color, so I just went for this. It's kind of like a sherbet feel. I don't really know how to describe it. It's pretty cool though. I like it because it's a lot brighter. Like, it's not as funky, like as loud, I'd say, as the lime design, but it's pretty cool. It's pretty chill. And yeah, we're just using black wheels. I'm going to just use black wheels for all of these designs just because I don't really feel the need to use colored wheels. So seeing as it's about the decal, more about the wheels. So that's what we're going to go with. So this is the first one. I like to use standard blue. I don't know how alpha boost right now because of Bacchus mod, but standard blue or blue sparkles looks really cool on this, and also a cobalt trail would look cool. The cool thing about like a tri-colored car like this though is you can pick out a boost color or a trail color that just matches any of these and it'll look cool. So you can have a cobalt one, you can have like a minty green one if you find one, or a pink one, like the laser wave for example. It all matches, which is really cool. Yeah, let's get on to the next design. And speaking of Henkovic, this is one of his presets that he uses. So it's a lime octane with a lime dune racer, and we have sky blue and red, and we have red and sky blue. So it's just like a palette swap, just like the last design. He uses metallic for the primary, and he uses matte for the secondary, which I find really cool because it gives like a little sparkly effect. And it's not as shiny if, for example, you use anodized pearl, which is like super shiny. So I kind of like this design as well. It's a color combination I haven't seen before, which I was really interested in when I watched one of his videos, because I think the color looks really cool. Any improvements I would say would be maybe like a darker color, because then, you know, you can bring out the other colors. Like if you do a bit more of a darker blue, it's a lot louder and it's a lot more funkier. But if you want it kind of chill, you can keep it on the normal colors he uses. I really do like this car. I just think that the lime... There's like a kind of weird thing with this car where I think the lime and the red and the sky blue looks kind of weird together. But hey, maybe that's just me. As boosts, I'm using a standard sky blue on this one and a standard crimson for the other side. He uses sparkles. If you do have the sparkles, you can use them. You can also just use standard sparkles or whatever you want. I personally just prefer to use the standard boost. And as trails, you can use Ruckus on this. Ruckus looks really good because it's crimson. So if you pick that up during the Chinese New Year event, then, or the Lunar New Year event, then that works really well. I also have a sky blue friction, which Ruckus is just crimson friction. Crimson, bleh, I can't speak. Crimson friction. I don't know why they called it like a different thing, because it's the exact same trail, but hey. So if you have a sky blue one like I do, you can use that too. Any other things, you can use light speed, basically just anything that fits sky blue or crimson or lime for both the designs. And yeah, so our next design will also be a lime dune racer, so let's get on with that. It's a pro design, so this will be pretty cool. And as you can see, our next design is Mark by 8, who is the Team BDS player, which is a team that's currently just tearing through EU, which is really cool. They've actually become my favorite EU team. I don't watch EU a lot, so I have a very fluctuant interest in the teams there. So I think BDS at the moment are my favorite team. And yeah, also because they have cool card designs, to be fair. Like, this is really cool. So yeah, let's get right into it. So it's a Lime Dune Racer, which I don't have because I'm not rich. Because at the moment it's like, I think the Dune Racers went up in price a lot. So yeah, and if you have one, definitely a big tip that I would give you is give it to me. Yeah. So that's the whole tip. So for the primary, we are using Anodize. I actually don't have Anodize. This is very embarrassing. So you can use Anodize Pearl. It's just that the Anodize Pearl gives off like a weird little sheen like this, if you see the difference. So this is anodized. And then if you like look at any pink part of the car, then it turns like light blue. So it does look a bit different, but I don't think it's too different to make it noticeable. But hey, if you're detailed focused like me, then it will annoy you, because it did annoy me, because I was looking for his paint finish and it did not look the way I wanted it to. So I did find out that it was anodized there. So we have anodized, and as the secondary, it's not really important what you pick. Like, you can just pick anything. I would recommend just sticking to glossy, seeing as the matte gives it like a weird texture, and glossy just leaves it really nice. And if you would pick anodize as well, I think that does work. So anodize or glossy is fine. We have the lightest sky blue, basically. So almost turquoise, I think. I don't know if this is turquoise or this is turquoise. I always learned this is turquoise, so that's how we're going to do it. We have the neon pink, just like on my first cobalt design. Then on the flip side, we have the pink color. And then we have the sky blue as the secondary. So yeah, this is a really cool car. If you are wanting to have like the exact same car, we have Cristiano's as the wheels. As the boost, he actually uses a standard. He actually just uses standard orange, which really confuses me. I had to look at multiple replays to make sure that I was looking right. But yeah, he uses orange. So I think he's probably using Bacchus mod to do alpha boost or some stuff like that. So go for this if you really want to be perfect, but if not, I would recommend using a sky blue boost or a lime blue boost if you have that too. Moving on to the gold explosion, we have sky blue Radrog. Use this if you want to do the car perfectly. Just want to tell you this, seeing as you're here. And the trail is a Laser Wave 3 in sky blue. I know some people watch these videos to actually get pro player car designs, so that's kind of what I am going with. So I can give you all the information, basically. Yep, so that has been it for these car designs. I'm now going to move on to two of my own I made. So this car is something I've called the Flexmobile, because if you have a titanium white Dune Racer, which I think is more expensive than the lime one, yeah, you're definitely flexing. I also added the titanium white Octane, because why the hell not? This is more of like a Bacchus mod like design, you know, because or if you do have these items, I feel very jealous of you. So we're using the titanium white Octane, we're using the titanium white Dune Racer. Now I want to make it really tryhardy, so I used the darkest primary matte and I used black. What you can also do though, you can use like a lighter color, which makes it really cool. Or what you can also do is use a dark primary and a light secondary to also give it like a cool little look. Let me just do this, something like this, right? So on the red side, we're doing the same thing, but also you can also do this kind of look to it, you know, to, or maybe something like this. So it's like a dark primary and a light secondary. This looks pretty cool in my opinion, and the white just makes it really clean. So yeah, boost I'm using for this one is a titanium white standard, because it fits nicely to the white, and because of the tryhardy nature of this car, when you do it this way, you can have a black light speed trail, which is pretty tryhardy. And then we have the titanium white dueling dragons. So just an overall Flexmobile, or if you really want a cool Bacchus mod car, this is something you might want to try out. So yeah, let's go on to the next one. This is going to be a... Never mind then. So let's move on to our last car design, which is going to be a budget one. Yay! People can actually afford this one. Woo! Right, so this might be a bit cheating because it's not really too budget actually, but hey. So I had a look at the prices again and they've gone drastically up since I last looked. So the cheapest painted Dune Racer you can get is a burnt sienna one. So it's 1k to 1.2, which I think is affordable, you know, for like, I think the average player, like if you save up, if you do some trading, you can get 1k pretty easily. So I went back and I remembered I did this design, I think like a year ago, which was this one. So someone asked me to do a Sovereign AT Burnt Sienna design, so I used the Dune Racer and I used the Burnt Sienna one. So I thought I would go back to that and kind of recycle it, but also show you as well, because I don't think anyone really sees the car designs I did like a year ago, because I did them on my stream, and my stream is now dead, so there you go. Anyway, so we have a Burnt Sienna Octane, which isn't worth that much. Then we have the Burnt Sienna Sovereigns, which is 400 to 500 credits, and we have the Burnt Sienna Dune Racer. So if you want to pick up one like really, really desperately and you only have 1,000 credits, I'd recommend the Burnt Sienna one because it's the only one you can afford. I definitely wouldn't recommend just getting an unpainted one, seeing as you can't do two different colors, and I think this decal really only works if you have two colors on it. The second cheapest is the Cobalt, which I showed at the beginning. So that's 1,300 credits at the moment. So that's pretty cheap as well. I mean, it's only 300 credits more, so that's fine. So let's get into details. We're using a Burnt Sienna Octane. We are using a Burnt Sienna Dune Racer. Then we have the Darkest Primary on the blue side in metallic. Now we're using this because there's nothing really, there's no colors that really fit to here that we're using. So the blue side is just kind of a throwaway with a dark primary. So the car can just be made out of the Burnt Sienna and the light colors. As a secondary, we're using the cream color. That's what I kind of dub it as. It's like vanilla cream, you know, and we're using that in matte. And then on the orange side, we are using a dark red. You can also just use any of this top row, just whatever shade you want. So if you want it to match the Burnt Sienna, you can do that. If you want it a bit lighter, you can do that. It's all up to you. We are using the metallic for this one as well, and the cream secondary for this as well. Now I'm using the secondary kind of to match the treads of the Sovereign ATs, and we're trying to match the Burnt Sienna with the Burnt Sienna, which isn't hard. So yeah, there you go. As a boost, I'm using the normal standard, just the orange. It fits. If you have a Burnt Sienna or Sparkles or whatever, you can use that too. As the explosion, I'm using Meteor Storm in case that interests you, and the friction as the trail. But as I said, with any of the designs I do, trails and boosts is just dependent on what you have and what's matching. So, and if not, just use Sparkles. That's kind of what my rule is for it. I mean, I have a lot of car designs in my presets where I don't match the colors because I just use Alpha Console anyway, so, oh, like Bacchus mod Alpha Console, so it doesn't really matter. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed these Dune Racer designs. Let me know what you thought in the comments below, and if you want any other design episodes, let me know.